day and in this week and the remaining days of this month, whatever you desire from God, heaven will be glad unto you. No one can deny your blessing in this day. And this week will be most favorable week for you in Jesus' name. I say this week is going to be the most favorable week for you in Jesus' name. If you believe, let your amen be louder.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hear me and hear me very well. You need not to expect when the prophet touched you for you to be blessed. But when the prophet speak the word, that word be established by God. When the word from the mouth of the prophet came forth, you claim it with a louder amen so that it will be done in your life. Because the Bible said in 2 Chronicles 20:20, believe the Lord, you shall be established. But when you believe his prophet, you shall prosper. It shows that your prosperity is in the hand of the prophet. And when he decree and declare, you receive it. I said this week you shall be blessed.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Open your Bible with me in the book of Luke, Gospel chapter 10. Luke, Gospel chapter 10. This morning and this day I preach a message entitled Passionate Ministry. Say passionate. Passionate ministry. Tell somebody by your side, you need passionate ministry. Touch the person behind you, you need passionate ministry. Hallelujah. Passionate ministry. Luke 10:30-35. I read. Please help your neighbor to get where we are reading. The gospel according to St. Luke 10. From 30, the word said. And Jesus answered, said, a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among thieves, fell among robbers and poor men, which strike him, they gave him blows, they beat him out of hell, and they let him remain lifeless with many wounds, and they departed and left the man dead. And by chance, here came down a certain priest, a man of God, a pastor, a bishop, a deacon, an elder, a leader, a prophet. And when this man came, he saw this young man with half life. He passed by the other side and go his way. And likewise a Levite, when he saw, here he was on his way coming, he came and looked at him, and he passed by the other side. But a certain Samaritan, say a certain Samaritan. But a certain Samaritan, as he journeyed, man was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him. And went to him and bound him up on his shoulder, pouring in oil and wine, and setting on his own beast, which is his own horse, and brought him to an inner room, to a place that they will take care of him. The host has said unto them, take care of him, and whatsoever thou spend more, when I will come again, I will repay you. May the Lord bless you spirit in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Beloved brethren, I preach this morning compassionate ministry. Many people in the Lord, in the church, has become lions, crocodiles, and dogs. Kill him, massacre him, stab him to death. The ministry of Jesus is not all about killing and destroying. It's a compassion. The ministry of Jesus is not crucify him, judge him, and nail him. It's a ministry of compassion. A man called himself a priest that knew the word of God, but he was with words, doctrine, not with God. Hear me and hear me well. There is different from religion and the Christianity. There is different from doctrine and being in the Lord. To be too religious is to be carnal minded. I want to tell you, beloved brethren, something happened in the book of Luke 10 from 35, from that 30 to 35. The man that was strived to have life happened to be an Israelite. And I want to show you something you need to know. Israelite and Samaritan have nothing in common. Israelite and Samaritan doesn't associate. They doesn't agree. They don't communicate. They don't drink together. They don't eat together. Israel saw Samaritan people as an outcast. Israelites saw Samaritan people as who? Outcast. But the man was an Israelite. An Israelite priest saw him jump and then pass. An Israelite Levite saw him jump and then pass. But a Samaritan, somebody from the enemy country, somebody from the outcast country, somebody from dejected and rejected country, he was not a priest, he was not a Levite, he was not a reverend, he was not an elder, he was not a deacon, he was not a prophet, but he has compassion. He has what?
Compassion.
Compassion. He has compassion. He has compassion. He has compassion. At the way Jesus went and saw a woman that was drawing the water. Woman of where? Samaritan. And Jesus asked this woman, Madam, I am thirsty. Give me some water to drink. The woman saw Jesus and asked him, you are a Jew. You are an Israelite. Why do you ask water from me? Israel and the Samaritan has nothing in common. And I want to tell you, beloved brethren, it's not all about religion. It's not all about your country people. It's not all about your village people. It's not all about your language people. people that speak the same language with you is the people that will sell you. People that is living with you is the people that will expose you. Samaritan woman asked Jesus, "You are asking water from my hand. Remember, I came from an cursed country. Will you drink water from me?" But Jesus made her to know, "I am the water of life." With Jesus, there is no racism. With Jesus, there is no barrier. With Jesus, there is no language barrier. With Jesus, there is no color barrier. With Jesus, there is no tribalism. Compassionate ministry. Compassionate ministry. I want to tell you, beloved brother, this is the high time we need to be more spiritual than to be more carnal. Spirituality connects you to everyone lovable. Why carnality lead you to racism and be jobatized? Say jobatized. Jobatized. Let me hear somebody say jobatized. Carnality lead to jobatized. Why spirituality lead to lovable and welcomeable? Lovability is the opposite of hateability. Am I talking to somebody here? Criticability is an opposite to welcomeability. what threats? Christ. Christ. But I come that you may have life. What God will give you, friends will not give it to you. What God will do for you, friends cannot do it for you. It's better you look for God, not for friends. I want to tell you, beloved brethren, there are too many diversions, too many dimensions of the attack of the devil. Number one, they came with nakedness. Number two, they came with wretchedness, poverty. Number three, they came with a physical pain. Number four, they came with injury. Number five, they came with hurt, to hurt you. They came with different attack, many dimensions, to bring you down, put you in sorrow, put you in cry, put you in trouble, put you in sleepless night, only to kill your future. Ordinary religious man, ordinary religious woman has no relief to offer. Am I talking to somebody here this morning? Ordinary religious man has nothing to offer. Don't play religious, don't be a religious, but be spiritual. The Bible said that the canal is fighting against the spirit. The canal always fights against the spirit. Hear me well. If you want to build your spiritual life, if you want to be a radical child of God, if you want to be a prayerful child of God, if you want to be a visioner, if you want to be a prophet or prophetess, if you want to be a pastor or a leader that wants your spiritual life to grow, let me tell you, depend not on the physical things. Look not on the physical things. Mind not the physical things. And never let your body control you. Never let your body put you to subjection. But put your body to subjection, that the spirit will arise and you may be elevated. The things you see control you. When you allow what you have control you, I want to tell you, lose the word that came from God. Every time you hear me well. If you want to be spiritual, don't be carnal. Only spiritual man overcomes flesh. Only spiritual woman overcomes the world. The world is full of iniquity. The world is full of attack. The world is full of warmongers. The world is full of evil things. But when you are spiritual, before they will gather, the God who you serve will scatter them and give you victory over them all. Carnality never offer anything good. It's only to bring someone down. They are here.
Yeah.
Hear me well, beloved brethren. Run away from religion and run into reality with God. Run into reality relationship with God. Run away from religion. Run away from tribalism. Run away from language. Run away from background. Run into reality relationship with God. The highest friendship you have is friend with God. The highest brother you have is brother with God. The highest neighbor you have is neighbor with God. Man can be surprised, but God will stand for you. Man can reject you, God will break you. Man can abandon you, God will raise you higher. Man can attack you, man can reject you. But God is by your side to bring you up. Whoever God bring it up can never go down. Whatever man do is a man chicken change. Because God is taking you to somewhere. I'm looking somewhere. Despite what they do, despite what they say, I am looking somewhere. I know who I serve. He will not let me down. Hallelujah. For you to move forward is not in the hand of your enemies, it's in your hand. They may decree, but when you arise, the declaration of your enemy goes down. Your destiny is not in the hand of your enemies. Let me tell you, hear me well. Anyhow they like, let them tell your story. Anyhow they like, let them reflect your past. But I want to tell you, they cannot overcome your presence.
Right on, sir.
I was somewhere a few weeks ago, outside Panama, I was telling people, I am a moving train. And if you cross my way, I bring you down.
Yes, sir.
Beloved brethren, you need to be a moving train. Don't let what you are seeing now stop you. Let your mindset be where you're going. And I want to tell you, whenever you're moving, there must be a distraction. But don't let them stop you.
Amen.
If you're not being distracted, it shows that you're going nowhere. If you're not being distracted, it shows that you're not on the way. But whenever you arise to take off, there must be a distraction. But never mind. I say never mind. I said never mind. I said never mind. I said never mind. I said never mind. You shall succeed. It is by His grace, not by your power. What you need is to contact the grace. And be more spiritual than carnal. Hear me well. If you want to be great in anything you do in life, in business, in marriage, in ministry, in the place of work, if you want to be great, allow temptation to come so that you have your testimony. Allow trials to come so that you can triumph. Allow challenges to come so that you will be champion.
Amen.
Allow a trial to come so that you will testify.
Amen.
The Bible says that they shall arise, but not of the Lord. That they may do what? They may scatter. So whenever you see them scatter, arising, begin to rejoice. Because there is a greater thing ahead of you. Death will never arise against the person that has no future. Nobody attacks destinyless man. It's only he that carries a crown that the people attack, because he is the breadwinner. Don't say I will not be blessed, because people will fight me. He that gave you the blessing will protect you. Don't say I will not be rich, for the thieves and robbers not to attack me. I want to tell you, allow the blessing to come. Prosper. The God that gave you the power to make wealth, He will protect you from the enemies. Compassionate nation. Don't come to kill. Don't come to steal. Don't come to destroy. But you welcome. But accommodate. Be passionate. Be lovable. Despite where he or she is coming from. The language matters nothing. The background matters nothing. What matters is where we are going. Hear me very well. Whatsoever that seemed good in your eye for somebody to do for you, first of all, do it for someone. Are you hearing me? Anything that you like so much that somebody will do for you, be happy. Start from you. Do it for somebody. Anywhere. Your deliverance may be in the hands of they despise. Your deliverance may be in the hands of the despised. The man of Samaria was not an Israelite, neither a Jew. But he brought deliverance to an Israelite man. The man of Israel that was bruised was expecting his deliverance from his people. Because his people are too religious. Israelites saw themselves as after God, he became them. They find themselves that they too know Bible, they too know the law, and they too serve God. But when the man of Israel, like their brother, was brought down, all his people saw him jump and then pass. Don't expect your protection from your people. Don't rely on the people closer to you that they will protect you. Hope on God. Your deliverance may come from where you despise. Your deliverance may come from the where you rejected. Your deliverance may come from the place you never expected. Be laughable and welcomeable. You don't know who God will use to change your color. So I receive.
Friends. I knew that thou hearest me
to die. Unless what you are having is not from God. But even though it's from God, let them talk, gossip, gather, hold their meeting, carry their assignments. The word of God said, in one way they shall gather. But some of us, they shall scatter. Say, I am unstoppable. Whosoever God bless, don't attack him. If you attack him, you can't see blessing. Whosoever God bless, any man that is a carrier of prosperity, don't fight him unless you can prosper. Any man that carries anointing, don't fight him unless you fight God. Any man that God choose, God follow him. If you stop him, he bring you down. Nothing you can do to stop whom God is with, unless the person belongs somewhere. But if it's the God that created the heaven and earth, say, I'm unstoppable. When Jesus has spoken the prayer he prayed to God Almighty,
he prayed with a loud voice.
He cried with a loud voice.
Lazarus, come forth.
Lazarus, come forth.
And he that was dead.
He that was dead for four good days. The man that had decayed. The man that was lifeless. The man that the soul has departed from the body. But when Christ showed the compassionate, when Christ demonstrated the passionate, when Christ showed the sorrow, the sorry, the importance of the ministry of compassion, the death came back to life. Not only said it showed it.
It's not-
must move forward. Hear me well. According to Bible, Lazarus has been in the tomb for 4 days. Inside the tomb, inside the grave, 4 good days. I don't know how many years you have been in that misery. I don't know how many years you have been in that sorrow. I don't know how many months you have been in that cry. I don't know how many years you have been in that joy party. I don't know how many years you have been in that miserable situation. I don't know. I don't care to know. But I bring Jesus who rose Lazarus. I minister Jesus who rose Lazarus. I bring Jesus who brought me where I am today. And he will bring you where you will be. I minister Jesus who changed my level. And he will change your level. I minister Jesus who visited my life. He will visit your life. Hey! So I need it. Whether they like it or not. Whether they like it or not. I am moving forward. Lift up your right hand. praise.
Amen.
You are going to praise.
Oh, yes.
Say, my father, my father.
Any JC member
assigned against my life.
Any JC
member
woman
assigned against my life.
As I
begin to pray. We will take power. We will. Lazarus was a man that was assigned to move forward. Spirit of death came to me in the grave. But Jesus appeared. So Lucy let him go. Now he was let go. Lazarus was in prison one place for 4 days. Your own may be 5 years. Your own may be 10 years. Today he was let go. I care not to know who came today. I care not to know what you did to be there. But I have assignment to the Lord. I am appointed by Holy Ghost to lose the Lord, to lose the path that you move forward. Today, as you are here, hearing the sound of my voice, you must move forward. Whether you like this or not, because you are here, you must stand the level.
To me and my household. But if
anointing. If you see that gave me this power, if you see that gave me this grace, if you see that choose me from my mother's womb, Father, as I speak, bless me and my people.